Hey everyone, and welcome back to Final Fantasy 15. The 1.05 update just released, and we are gonna check out what's new. So first off, the Moogle Chocobo Carnival has ended, so hopefully you got a chance to go and check it out because it's gone now, and I assume it's gonna be gone until the same time next year. So we got some new stuff beyond things getting removed. If we go to our menu, you can see all my characters are level 99, but look at that. There's experience to the next level. The level cap has been raised to 120, and I assume it's going to take a monstrous amount of experience because just to get to level 100 is over a million experience, and I've got to assume that it's going to be like before where each level is going to be more experience than the previous one. So lots and lots of experience necessary to get up to that new level cap. Alright, we also have an increase to the amount of pitchers the Prompto can take. And I don't actually remember what the old limit was. I think it was 150. It's now 200. So more pitchers that you can take. And of course, with that last update, you can take pitchers manually. So you've got Prompto taking his automatic pitchers, plus you can take your own. So that's nice for those of you who really like photos. And also, I've been meaning to, I just haven't found any time. Some people have been asking to see my photos. I was going to put together an album for you to check out. I'll do that whenever I get some time. I've just been super busy. So I did not forget about you guys. At some point, I will make an album for you. Okay, what else do we got? We got these new timed quests. So let's go ahead and click that. And you can see our current timed quest is... let's see, that area is near the Kothis rest area, just by the Imperial Fort over there. I forget what the fort's name is. The target is Cactuars and Slactuars. It's active to anyone that's on Chapter 1 or further, so basically everyone. And look at these bounties, or look at the bounty rewards, just insane. 10,000 experience, 333 AP, 150,000 gil, and 2 Oracle Ascension coins. And these timed quests are repeatable. However, if you repeat it, you're not going to get all the rewards. You're just going to get the experience on all the subsequent runs. So, unfortunately, you can't do it over and over again for that crazy AP. You're only going to get that AP, gil, and coins once. And then it's just experience after that. And this timed quest is going to be active until March 6th. So, you've got plenty of time to knock this one out. And then I assume on March 6th, there's going to be a new timed quest that becomes available. And that's pretty much all the other, all the changes. The only other one I'm aware of is you can now, there's a portable music player for chocobo riding. So I'm not sure where you get that. That's not something I've been showing on my videos because copyright scares me. But anyways, you can now listen to music on your chocobo, which you previously couldn't do. Alright, so let's go ahead and do this timed quest. So we want to head over to the Kothis rest area.
So how about a breather?
Okay, here we are. Let's see. Our chocobo rental has 4 days, so that's good. Let's go ahead and call the chocobo, and we'll ride over there. And on the way, I'm going to hit up a haven and get some food. Now, this hunt is low level. They're only, like, level 15. But they are Cactuars and Slactuars, which are some of the most annoying enemies in the game. They like to stun lock you, confuse you, and there's going to be a lot of them. So I highly recommend you actually come prepared. You could do this at lower levels, although I'm not sure how well that might work out for you. So you might want to make sure you're a little over-leveled on this, or just make sure you are very prepared, because there's going to be, I believe there's 100 of them we have to kill. And there's usually going to be about 6 or 7 active at a time, so they can be difficult to deal with. You're going to have a really hard time at low levels, but I shouldn't have any trouble whatsoever. I should just blow these guys up. And I'm just getting the food buff to speed it up, make sure I don't get stun locked too bad, anything like that. Make sure my attacks are doing so much damage they just melt. And just make this super easy for myself. Let's see, Haven's right over here. And I'll most likely make some crispy skewers or whatever they're called. That awesome food I like to carry around with me.
Thanks for the ride. Aw, thanks. Ugh, I'm all sticky and gross.
Woohoo! Bath time!
Hey, look at that. Report card. Haven't even played in weeks, but I did something at some point. I think it's been weeks. It feels like I haven't played forever. Let's see. That's the stuff we got from the Chocobo Carnival. Not that we want to make it, but it's added to our list. So yeah, I can make some Crispy Zoo skewers. Max health, critical hit rate, 80%. Or I could go with the Golden Tail Soup. Gives me crazy health regen, although I don't really need that. Either one works. Let's see, which one do I have more ingredients for? Alright, Crispy Zoo Skewers wins. And, we don't really need greens, but... sure, we'll use Silkus greens. Why not? So you can see I'm at 465 AP, and I'm going to get another 333 at the end of this, which will put me around 800. So I'm going to have a lot of AP. Let's see, any pictures I want to keep? Sure, let's keep one of Gladio. I've got more slots now, I don't have to be as selective.
Perfect timing.
That must have been when I fought the Angelus, but nothing too good. Alright, and let's make sure I'm all prepared for this fight. We'll go to my gear. Might use some of the new stuff. Zwill, crossblades will work. I don't want a javelin. I want a sword. However, Balmung isn't a good choice for me because I'm going to be doing a lot of warp striking. And the higher your MP is, the more damage this does. So instead, I'm going to go with the Ultima Blade. And let's see, I got two Dark Matter Bracelets and a Magitek Suit. I might use one of these, actually. We got the Tech Turbocharger, a device for Noctis that accelerates the tech bar replenishment rate, but freezes the armature bar. I think I want to do that because Gladio's Impulse technique is fantastic for this hunt. So I think I want to try this out. I've never used it either, so I want to give it a shot. And, oh, and let's actually get a real outfit on. As much as I love this outfit, let's go back to my kingly raiment. There we go. Okay.
Let's hit it.
All right.
We are ready to head over. So it doesn't mark it on your map. You just need to be familiar with the territory. But it's really just on the other side of this giant crater here. So just go past that and then further back into the woods, and you really can't miss them. They'll have the exclamation marks over their head, and there's gonna be 100 of them, but not all at once. They'll kind of come in waves. Let's see, I think it's back here in this clearing. Let's see, let me open up my map actually. No, that's not it. It's off this way, and I can't sprint. There we go.
Blessed weather.
All right, over here somewhere, maybe this clearing? Yep, this is it. Just saw an exclamation mark. Although it promptly disappeared. Oh, there it is. Although, where's my counter? There should be a counter showing me my progress on this. But it's not there. Maybe that's the wrong one? Oh, get out! That was weird, that barely did any damage.
Couldn't stop.
Okay, well, apparently that wasn't my hunt. Maybe something went wrong.
Bring on the next one.
Well, you can see the exclamation mark right here. Maybe I have to get, like, right on it. I didn't have to do this before. Oh, weird. I never had to activate it before. Well, I guess I have to. Undertake this timed quest. Yes. Accepted. Target 0 of 100. And I'll... Whoops. As you can see, I haven't played for a little while. Oh, wrong button again. Okay, I'm good now. And I mostly will be probably using these Zilquas blades. As long as I'm quick, they shouldn't be able to damage me much. My technique's ready. Let's go ahead and fire it off. It should just kill everything. Let's see, we're at 4 out of 100. And now 7. So it killed 3 at least. My god, so much damage with these daggers. Oh, I got confused. That was one thing I forgot to mention. You might, if you have a ribbon, you might want to consider using it. Or whatever item it is that prevents confusion. Because confusion can be a bit of a pain.
That was close.
And man, that tech accelerator works really well. Look at that. I'm almost ready to fire off a 3 tech again. Let's do it. Oh, he's confused. I can't yet. I'll wait till his confusion wears off and the health's actually getting a little low. Should probably be a little careful. Actually, there's no reason for me to be careful. Let's just pump it up so my daggers are doing max damage again.
You rang?
There we go. Gladio's still confused, apparently. I'm taking too much damage. Let's just go with the sword. The sword will work just fine. Ow. Alright, Gladio's ready. Impulse. 16 out of 100 to 19.
What did you expect?
Only 3. Apparently that shockwave doesn't go behind him. Otherwise these guys would be dead too. And you can see these actually drop really good items. Mega potions, remedies, some good stuff.
If I may.
Yeah, get some AP from that Link Strike. See, we're almost at the fourth of the way mark. These evil thousand needle attacks. Tear me up.
You're on fire today.
Okay, let's see. Let's try the cross blades again. Put in, we'll just use a high potion. Impulse is ready. Fire that off. Oh, I can't. Gladio is too confused.
Never knew what hit him.
See, my daggers actually still might be the better damage, even if I'm not max HP. They're doing some pretty nice damage. Gladio, can you do it yet? Yes, he can. Ooh, this could get a bunch of them. Oh, they're all behind him. Oh, well, it got him anyway.
Nice work,
Gladio. Stop hitting me! Yeah, I think the crossblades are probably still the best option. Even when I'm not at full, just because they hit so fast, just gets rid of them before they can do anything. Although I do need to get myself back up. They really did pick the most annoying enemies for this first timed hunt, or timed quest.
You're mine.
Let's go back to my sword. Ah, can't hit him. Ah, whatever. Impulse as soon as Gladio's all better. Eat that. And we're not even halfway. There's so many of them. And all these mega potions just getting wasted. Oops. Alright, Gladio's ready. Impulse time. Well, there's only a few near him. Oh, more than I thought.
Nice work, Gladio.
Oh yeah, these cross blades. Just so much damage.
That's that.
Just as long as I can keep moving and killing. They don't seem to be able to hit me with their abilities. So I should just do that. Just keep warp striking around. Yeah, that's where it's at. Although I'm gonna run out of AP if I keep doing this. I'm in stasis. Gladio's confused. Well, you know what I can do? I can just point warp. There we go. And back to the slaughter. After the impulse. Noctis' turn. Oh my god. They're all spread out from his great. Warp Strike is practically one-shotting them. Oh, took a hit. Get out of there. Oh, thousand needles. And I'm already back up to 2 tech. Yeah, that tech accelerator. Insane. We're sorely overmatched. I don't think you quite got that one right, Ignis. Okay, over here, we'll impulse. 73 to 75, that's it. Oh, 9999. Oh, that's weird. That warp strike barely did anything to him.
Gladio seems to be touch.
Again? You'll die.
Let's see, 20 more. Oh, I'm in stasis. What's point warp? Much better. Back in. Ow, 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 ow. Impulse! Look at that dude chilling. Oh, that's hilarious. 16 more. Oh, missed that warp strike. Hey, get back over here. There you go. Slippery cactuar. Too fast. How dare you? Confusion has me switching weapons here. Just gotta be careful not to leave the area. I did that before and it abandoned the quest, which really sucked. I was pretty far in.
No big deal.
So let's see, only 6 left. Make that 5. Where are they hiding? Here's one. There's another. Oh, missed that one. Oh, he got me with his needle strike. Ow! It hurts! Alright, one more. And I'm in stasis.
Nice save!
Ah. And he is dead. Complete. Earn 10,000 experience. Earn 333 AP.
That was a close one.
Got my 2 Oracle Ascension coins. Got some Phoenix down for something.
Just being alive.
Huh?
And we completed it. So if we go to our timed quest, you can see now it has 1 completed. So like I said, even though it still shows 333 AP and 150,000 gil and 2 Oracle Ascension coins, that is only for the first time. So you'll get the experience again, but that's it if you decide to repeat it. All right, so that's pretty much everything there is with this update. I could get up to level 120 if I wanted to, but I think I'm just gonna wait for DLC to come out, because it kind of seems pointless to just level for no reason. So I'll just let my levels happen naturally as the DLC comes out. So, either whenever the new timed quest comes out or the next DLC, which I think the next DLC is coming first, I'll be back on this game. But until then, there will be no Final Fantasy. But we won't be gone for too long. But that's going to do it for this video. So thank you for watching, and I will see you next time.